All right, John. That's the last of what I had to tell you. You with the rest of this, you can put it on YouTube or put it in the vault, whatever you want to do. Folks, I am, this is Yahweh. I am not on Delta Soul. I'm not on Earth right now. I am actually in the Zeta Reticular system on a small planet called Goranok. I've been living amongst the greys for, I don't know how what the equivalent in Earth time would be, not very long. It's the most time I've ever spent in this culture. It's quite a shock to me. It's brought here with the intent of hopefully tempering some of my more stark opinions on these beings. It's a very interesting place, teeming with life forms, but feeling very dead. The population, it's difficult to enumerate. In this system, hundreds of planets, trillions of people, beings. So much, so many of them, so many buildings, so many things, but yet very little color, very few right angles. It's just a very unsettling place. It's the horizon just kind of all blends in together. No matter where you go, it's very difficult, at least for me, it all looks the same. But I have had several of my opinions changed. I have met some individuals who have worked with Khalid, who many of you now know, is the third in the team that's replaced mine. I still don't know how they are planning on making Khalid appear human. But the Greys are masters at this type of thing, and I certainly am not going to second-guess them. There's been a lot of planning in what's about to unfold. And that's why I'm coming right now to you and wanting to talk about this. This is certainly no dire news. There's no reason to panic, but it's very unsettling to me. Apparently, they're leaders of your planet. These Jakku who have been running your governments around your world for the last, I don't know how many Earth years, 10, 20, have broken some promises with both your powers that be there and those that exist on a level, with due respect, I don't mean to sound condescending, but on a level that you just can't quite comprehend yet. These individuals, some of them have risen to power under questionable circumstances. Right now, my understanding is that there have been seeds planted around the Earth, around Delta Sol. Seeds in the forms of beings who appear to be Jakku, like you, but are not. I don't mean to scare you when I say this. I simply mean to inform you. The way it was explained to me, they've been there for quite a while. Would have been nice for me to know about that, but I made that opinion very clear. However, this decision was made above my head in the chain of command. Now, these beings have been placed around your planet to foster discontent, to stoke unrest in your subculture, your subclass, excuse me, the poor people of your planet. That they've been put in positions of, in some circumstance, great influence, great power, in labor organizations in particular. The stuff that is going on in the Middle East, and I have been privy to some of the news from Delta Soul. And may I say that when I heard what was going on in Syria, it really took me aback. I mean, for those of you that don't know, Syria is very good friends with Iran. And Iran cannot see the government in Damascus fall. That will become a very bloody conflict, I fear. And with Israel being right next door, things could get very, very dangerous very quickly. And friends, I wish you nothing but the best. It's my hope that I will be returning to your planet very soon. I believe I'm almost done here. I do have one item of concern that I need everyone's help with. The individual that took my place as leader of this new group of three, being by the name of Ond, he's a Nocturian, very, very intelligent. He matches so well your myth, your Antichrist myth. Reading over his briefings, his mission outline, if you will, they're setting this up for a story. Someone is. Someone set the stage and the actors are all in place. The curtain's about to be pulled back. And you're all going to see things that will shock you, amaze you, at times delight you. But rest assured, there is a thought out outcome. I'm stuttering. I've been speaking different languages for the last, what would be, I don't know how to describe the time. And I mustn't dilly-dally here. These recorders that you sent, John, are troublesome machines. I don't know if you painted over some of the lights or if I just can't see them right. I think I'm doing it right. Now, Ond is going to become very public in his presence. He will not go by the name Ond. And to be honest, I do not know what name he is using on Delta Sol. I hope to find that out as soon as I return. But that's what I need your help with. That's why, John, you should probably consider putting this one on YouTube. If you do, put some graphics on there. Be creative with the graphics. Make it something unique. Because when I get back, I am going to have a lot to say. I've experienced so much. The library on Nibiru, I could have never left. I could stay there the remainder of my days and be perfectly content within those walls. They're surrounded by ancient wisdom. And the tape I made there, I have to say I'm quite proud of. The stories that I found out about the transition from the fourth age of the Jakku to the present, the fifth age, the last 14,000 years before present time on Delta Sol to, I guess, what would be about 4,000 years before present time, that period of history that I was able to put on that recording, I think many of you will find absolutely fascinating. Ibanya was, I'm going to get choked up talking about this. I can't believe how much more homesick I am now than I was before I went home. Being gone for so long, I'd just forgotten so much. It just, you know, you put it away. And coming back home, I was all brought back out. And then before I knew it was over and I had to put it all back away again. But I'm very excited to get back. I will be leaving for sure permanently on December 21st, 2012. So I will have until then to tell you all everything I found out. And I found out some amazing stuff. I've got to tell you, the time that I spent on Earth, in your time, 3,500 of your Earth years, okay? The dozens of planets that I have contact, regular contact with, in your quadrant of the galaxy, their days are all different. Their months are different. Their lunar cycles, those of them that have moons, most of them do. Moons lend themselves very well to life, organic life. But you don't want to hear all about that. I know what many of you are going to want to know is, how did I get there? How did I get back? All these questions. Well, that's what I wanted to make this tape about, is, or at least include in this, is to put this out there for the vault thing that John and Tania and Khufu and Ray are doing. I would really like to be able to, in some way, have a sit-down question and answer. What do they call them? A chat? I'd really like to just answer questions, is what I'm saying. And I hope I get the opportunity to do that. I'm very excited to get back. But I do need your help. I need you guys to, those of you who listen to my voice and find any value in what I have to say. And that's the way we always talk about it in this project that I'm a part of on Delta Soul, is we try to use that word. The reason is because for you, Jaku, that term seems to associate with it something of worth, something of sacrifice, which is the point we're trying to get across. It's not a monetary value. It's something that tugs at your soul. That weight pulling down your pocket is me going along with you on your daily travels. That I'm the nagging voice now in the back of your head, that what if. And for those of you who hear that, I want to answer your questions in as direct a way as I can, because while 18 months may seem like a long time, trust me, for me, it's nothing. It's going to represent, what, 1,000th or 10,000th of my time with you people, you Jaku. Jaku, to me, are going to fit right in with the rest of the galaxy. You know why? Because you're creative. So many of you are thoughtful, creative, compassionate beings, just like the rest of us. Sure, there's some bad. Oh, I always get stunk when I... Did I just say stunk? I always get stuck when I try to think of a clever euphemism. It's impossible to tell how much time I've spent. I hope this is appropriate to do this. I don't know what day it is. I don't know what time it is back there. But John, if you could please put this up... Maybe please put this on YouTube with some creative graphics for fun. Maybe some Prince pictures, so you can get his attention and let him know that I very much appreciated the flowers. The flowers were delightful, Prince. Thank you very much for the flowers. Yes, there were 12 flowers. Oh, the colors. Well, they were all orange. Over and out.